The HEPA-AIRE PAS2400 from Abatement Technologies is the ultimate combination of power and portability. Exceptional performance and a full array of user-friendly features have made the PAS2400 portable air scrubber a popular choice for capturing airborne particles during facility construction and renovation. With peak tested airflow up to 2100 CFM and a maximum static lift of 5.5 inches, it's the highest output portable air scrubber that is NRTL certified to operate safely on a 120 volt, 15 amp electrical supply. The PAS2400 portable air scrubber has three filtration stages with exceptional capacity for capturing airborne particles and optional gas and odor removal capabilities. The first stage pre-filter is a 1-inch MERV-4 fiber trapper pre-filter. The second stage pre-filter is a 2-inch MERV-8 pleated particulate pre-filter. An optional, sold separately, third stage pre-filter is available. A 2-inch high-capacity MERV-8 vapor lock carbon filter for odors and other VOCs. The final stage HEPA filter is individually tested and certified to a 99.97% minimum efficiency at 0.3 microns, featuring a zero bypass design and true HEPA performance. A unique cabinet design and a true high-capacity IEST-compliant HEPA filter help ensure that the PAS2400 exhausts 99.97% plus efficiency air out of the work area, job after job, month after month. The PAS2400 is also mounted to a transport dolly that is equipped with a stair climber and 360-degree swivel casters. The transport dolly makes it easier to load and unload the unit from service vehicles and bring it up and down staircases. To facilitate transportation of the PAS2400 to and from the project site, the inlet and power modules can be separated. In addition to providing HEPA filtration, the PAS2400 units are primarily used in a negative pressure or recirculation mode. A negative pressure condition is created in order to confine contaminated airborne particles. This condition exists when the static pressure inside the room containing the unit is lower relative to the pressure of the environment outside the room. The static pressure differential is created and maintained by continuously exhausting air out of a given room at a faster rate than air enters the room from all other sources. In the recirculation mode, all of the filtered air is exhausted back into the room containing the unit. When used for recirculation, the PAS2400 can reduce concentrations of airborne contaminants in a room or area by continuously cleaning the air and exhausting it back into the same room or area. Abatement Technologies portable pressure monitors are recommended to ensure that negative pressure requirements are being met. To ensure that the proper pressure differential is maintained, the volume of HEPA-filtered air supplied to the area must be the greater of 10% or 100 CFM higher than the volume of air exhausted from it by the HVAC system. Before operating the PAS2400, ensure that the inlet module is resting flush on top of the power module and that the two modules are locked together with the rotating latches. Always inspect the HEPA filter retaining bolts as they can be loosened during transportation. If filters are removed for any reason before operating the PAS2400, always check that the arrows on the filters are pointing in the direction of airflow through the unit as they are put back into place. If using ducting, always make sure to use the minimum amount possible to avoid unnecessary airflow losses to external static resistance. The PAS2400 requires a minimum of 110 volts AC and 60 Hz to operate properly. However, maximum airflow performance requires 120 volts AC and 60 Hz. Due to momentary startup current surge, the unit requires a 15 amp circuit that is free of other loads. If the unit is connected to a circuit that is protected by fuses, be sure to use time delay fuses. Tension cords used for the PAS2400 must be UL listed, heavy duty, 12-3 American wire gauge, SJTW industrial grade 3-wire cord. The cord must be in good condition and in continuous lengths, never spliced together, and should not exceed a total of 50 feet in length. The PAS2400 should be plugged into a GFCI receptacle at the power source to protect the power cord and the unit. Check to ensure that any circuit to which the unit is connected is protected by a 15 amp circuit breaker. Make certain that any extension cords used do not reduce power to the unit less than 110 volts. Use of a voltmeter to confirm adequate voltage is recommended. Do not connect or disconnect the power cord to an electrical outlet unless the unit's main power switch is off. The control panel on the PAS2400 features a hardwired 10-foot, 12-3 American wire gauge, SJTW power cord for connection to electrical outlets. The unit's main power on-off switch, a rocker arm-style switch for putting the motor into high or low speed, a 15-amp circuit breaker that provides protection for the unit's electrical components, an hour meter displaying the total number of operating hours on the unit, and two separate filter change indicators for the pre-filters and HEPA filter. Check to make sure that the main power switch is in the off position. Plug the power cord into a 120-volt AC, 60-hertz, 15-amp supply circuit. Set the motor speed switch to high or low speed. When the motor speed switch is set to high speed, there is a momentary delay before the motor starts. Turn the main power switch to the on position. The green power indicator will illuminate, indicating that the main power switch is on and the unit is connected to the power source. There is also a momentary delay when switching the unit from low to high speed while it is running. Factory and independent testing at 120 volts AC estimates the low motor speed setting to be 700 CFM and the high speed setting to be 2100 CFM. Factors such as filter loading, reduced voltage to the motor, as well as inlet and outlet ducting can reduce airflow. Therefore, airflow ratings are to be used as a general guideline only. With the unit operating on high, turn the latches on the pre-filter access door counterclockwise and open the door. Remove the first stage filter and replace it with a new one. Make sure that the scrim side of the filter is facing down. Close the door, make sure it is flush against the cabinet, and lock it in position. If the filter change indicator for the pre-filters remains on after changing the first stage filter, the second stage filter should be replaced. Open the pre-filter access door. Remove the second stage filter and replace it with a new one. Make sure that the arrow on the pre-filter is facing in the same direction as the airflow of the PAS2400. Close the door and lock it in position. If the filter change indicator for the pre-filters remains on after changing the second stage filter, the third stage pre-filter, if one is being used, should be replaced using the same procedure as the second stage pre-filter. If an optional vapor lock filter is being used, be sure to remove it from its poly bag before installing it in the unit. Vapor lock filters are packaged in poly bags to preserve the integrity of the carbon granules. Turn the unit off and disconnect the power cord from the electrical outlet. Rotate the latches on the HEPA filter access door counterclockwise to release them and open the door. Using a half-inch nut driver, loosen the HEPA filter retaining bolts. Remove the corner brackets and metal discs. Remove the filter from the power module using the handles attached to the side of the HEPA filter. Carefully install a new HEPA filter inside the power module, gasketed end first until it is flush against its sealing surface. The HEPA filter is delicate and should be handled with care. Place the metal discs and corner brackets back into position and tighten the retaining bolts. Do not over-tighten the HEPA filter retaining bolts. Over-tightening the bolts could damage the HEPA filter frame and/or the mounting frame in the power module. Finally, close the HEPA filter access door and lock it in position. Proper personal protective equipment should be worn in accordance with all federal, state, provincial, local, and employer regulations. Along with appropriate PPE, precautions must be taken when disposing of dirty filters. Removal of dirty filters should be done in a contained area, and disposal of the filters should follow proper procedures for the type of contaminant that was being filtered. Be sure to use only Abatement Technologies pre-filters, HEPA filters, and replacement parts. Substitute parts void the warranty, jeopardize worker and environmental safety, and adversely affect engineered performance levels. We hope this helps while operating your HEPA-AIRE PAS2400 portable air scrubber, the most capable portable air scrubber in its class. If you have any questions, please feel free to call Abatement Technologies or contact your sales representative directly.